All right, we're going for no whammies this time. I think it's working this time. All right, we just had a little glitch there. Anyways, I explained this just a second ago, but I'll explain it again. Today's task is to work on this scene right here. I'm bringing this to life. This is a new scene where you learn to meditate in this alternate dungeon where it's mostly puzzle-based. And through solving these puzzles, you get to this point and you learn your meditation skill. And then when you learn the meditation skill, you can open these big old doors, and these doors slide into these walls. So I'm working on that today. But first thing I need to do is work on making the boss doors data-driven. So this, I already have a bunch of code written. So these big doors can slide and play all this noise and do the screen shake and all the cool stuff that happens when big doors open. So I need to make it data-driven so that I can use this kind of art instead of and settings and all that instead of the existing boss door. So that's what I'm working on right now. Okay, so the first thing I need to do is like make this a little simpler. I think these are all sidewalls. This is the left bottom door. It's the left door. Boss doors are not top bottom. So this is the sidewall. Just simplifying this stuff. A dungeon where Rock learns Krav Maga. Nice. All right, so I'm pretty sure that's simplified that. Just make sure the boss doors that are in the game I haven't broken already. Oh. So many little things to remember when I do these live streams. Oh, plug in the headphones, plug in this, blah, blah, blah. Doors should still work. Yeah. All right, we're good. Next thing is to make this all data driven. Let's go with all the sidewalls and extra collisions first. We open up entities. Ay, ay, ay. Life chest. Boss door, level 2. Okay, so this thing's gonna have children. Entities. Oh, tea is so nice. It's kind of like, it's like a warm, cold day today outside. It's all windy. So it's like, it's sunny, but it's windy and cold. Kind of. Okay, so children, let's go left. This is the left side. Okay, and as render image, color type rock. Position, the given position, minus 45 there, minus 2 there. All right, so that should do that sidewall. Oh, and a Z order offset of 2. Mid plus 2. Hello, Bithext. What's up, man? High five. Okay, already, let's see if this is starting to work. So I'm going to take that out real quick and take out the left side wall. And now we run this and we shouldn't have a left wall. Awesome. No left wall. Still has a collision though. I'm not sure why. Oh, there's different collisions. Okay, great. Now if I throw back in the entity, or I add in this entity for the new thing we just created here. Oh wait, we already have this data on this auto entity calls the data, create the entity. And push. Thinking if I should make a separate version of this function. I guess I could just go. I need a new auto entity function. So area.h. What's the purpose of the meditation skill? It oh wow, there's a lot to it. Oh my gosh, I don't want to say too much. I don't want to give away too much, but the meditation skill will unlock secrets. It will help you solve puzzles. Not help you solve puzzles, it will actually be key and instrumental into solving some puzzles. There's a lot to it, and it's central to the completing the game. Once you finally, once you figure out, it's going to be every boss has something to do with the meditation skill too. So you have to beat the boss, and then you also have to use your meditation skill to destroy something, which I will show, I will announce it soon. I'll start drawing some cool stuff. You'll be like, what's that? And we'll be like, what? What? And then we'll be like, look, you know what I mean? Oh yeah, there was no commentary. Yeah, I only had like a minute of commentary in yesterday's video, and then I said, "Okay, yeah, I'm just gonna do my thing without talking." So it was actually really interesting to do pixel art, sort of for a video, but not explaining everything I do. It was nice to just kind of artistically flow, in that sense. I don't think that same kind of video would work with programming, because with programming I kind of have to explain what's going on in my head, but. Yeah, it was actually really refreshing to do a video like that. And also, I hope it was nice because it was high quality, too. And lots of people have been asking for high quality videos again. and it sucks that my internet, I can't do the stream at high quality, but I can record videos at high quality and at least release those. So that's good. Okay, so why is this failing here? Oh, I think autoEntity might be a static function. Nope. Oh, pause. What's up, Jonah? Welcome to the stream. Okay, now this will work with the data. All right, so if that works, we'll have a boss door, or the sidewall will be on the left again. What are we up to? Let me show you. All right, it worked, but the position's off, so we'll fix that. What I'm working on today is this. This is a new skill you're gonna have, where you can meditate, and it helps you. It's a skill that you can use. So it's part of puzzles. You can solve puzzles that way. For example, the first time you use it, you get it inside the first alternate dungeon, which is mostly puzzle based. So you solve all these puzzles, you get to this point, you learn the meditation skill at the end of the dungeon, and then you open up these gates using your meditation skill. And then it's going to be instrumental in how you get through. You mark each dungeon as completed, basically, using your meditation skill. I won't explain too much of it. New boss? No new boss. Just the meditation skill. So what I'm working on right now is the boss doors. These big doors, I'm making those data-driven so that I can use this art instead of the current art. So the position was minus 25 there. We need to add that into the... So this is not just 45, it's 50, 70. Yeah, and so this is also the kind of the beginning of doing puzzles. I won't be actually working on puzzles today, but sometime this week I will be working on puzzles, because I want to get some puzzles into this next update. Oh yeah, so we got, once again, we have this side of the boss door. Great. Now I can get, I don't need to get rid of that just yet. Let's do these other side walls. Let's turn all this off now. Okay, so we don't have anything on the right, but we still do have those. Interesting. Oh, Oh, those must be static tiles. I forgot about those. Yeah, those are static tiles. Yeah, so I just got to make these data driven here, the next sidewall and the extra collision. This is plus 25 to begin with, so plus 25, but yeah, that just comes out to be positive 70. And then we're doing the right door, same thing, colored rock, same Z order. And that's based on the original position. So where this one is going to be position, negative two block size. I think I can do negative two B there. Okay, so collision component. One B, three B, three B. Oh, that's area size, y minus block size. I think these both need to be like positive four or something like that. I'm just gonna do one at first to make it really obvious. And I'm gonna turn off the doors as well. Okay, I'm gonna now see if these extra collisions are coming up correctly and put those in the right positions. I put them right there in the middle, so the negative 2B didn't work for the position. Okay, so position component. Oh, this needs to be block position. Collision component does it. Collision component sets its size or its position. No, its size. Yeah, based on block size. So. Constants parse block size, data get child size. Yeah. So we want to parse block size from data.getString and parse that into pause. So that, I'm going to set a breakpoint there and make sure that works. So simplifying systems here, that's what I'm doing. I'm working on this, getting some new art here into the game. And I'm simplifying some existing systems to make it easier next time. So next time I want to do some big boss doors that look like this, I can do it much, much easier. So the data got passed in, it is position 0015. So let's make sure 0015 comes out as a block size just fine. String, cool. Block size, separator, vector, split. Yeah, no block size. All right, so if I step out of this method, my pause should be 0015. Cool. That works. So now positions can be automatically block size based. So this time when we run it, we should see a position that's a little to the left of the middle of the door. Yeah, you found a major bug in your pathfinding. Nice job, T. Yeah, there's those extra collisions right here. And it does look like they need to go up by one. Wait, no. One, two, three, four, five. Whoa. So that should be six. Let's make sure it is six. We'll do six and five there. One of them should be wrong. Yeah, so the one on the right's wrong. Okay. Got it. Now we got these extra collisions dialed in. Totally independent of the entity. Or totally independent of area size, which the old code was. Which is, you know. Alright, cool. Yeah! Alright, next up, let's get the rest of. So I can get rid of all these sidewalls if I want. But we need to do the right door and the left door. So let's do the left door. Position, -25, 0. Profile, 1, boss, door. Render is going to automatically load the profile's idle animation, collision component, ahoy salad dongs, yar, ahoy, that was me doing seagull. Couldn't you tell? Size. Okay, this is all. I'm so glad to be taking all this code out. And this is awesome because this will take like 80 lines or something like that away from the total line count. Size. 50. Block size dot y times 4, which is just 4b. 50. And lastly, it needs a door component, but so far we don't have a door component data yet. But oh, and render needs a negative 1. Wait, where did I got rid of render. Oh, there it is. Render. So you order mid. There. Okay, so now we should have a left door, not a right door. Dare you to insert a clip of you making that noise as a sound effect in the game? Do you dare me? Okay, so yeah, this is looking good. Now it just needs to be colored right and have the other data that is applied dynamically. But where does it do that? Oh, color comes from... the item color and stuff. Yeah, so we can go system int off of the automatic entity and if the render's not empty, we can just go render.sprite. Oh, this isn't going to work for both the doors, though. I got a better idea. I think I can do this from within the door component, actually. Yes, what I'm doing. Yep, I'm taking away all this code and making it data driven. This is so what I'm doing here is I drew this yesterday. This is a mock-up of this. You're using your meditation skill. It's a new skill that player is gonna have or be able to get. And these big doors open up when you use your meditation skill in front of them. So that's what I'm working on right now. I'm taking the existing code for the boss doors, the big doors, and making them so it works with other types of doors. So data-driven boss doors. So yeah, thanks, man. Yeah, this is where it uses like the door, the condition, and all that stuff. All that could be loaded from the door component. So we got left door, right door. So we'll have a child that's door R, and it should have everything that the other door has, except for position 25, same there. Wait, I guess the right door doesn't have anything to do with the Z order offset. So that simplifies that, I guess. Oh, and it has negative movement. Oh, but both of these, neither of these even have door components yet. Oh, is that right? Oh, we also need a skin. Okay, let's see if we even have a right door now. Great, we have the door. Then neither of these should open. Good. Okay, so now I need to make door components so they're data-driven. Haven't done that yet. This is all very good stuff to be finally doing. Okay, so door components, I'll now be able to create a door component from data instead of from all these parameters. Door component dot h. So we're just gonna initialize a door component with only data. Okay, so all these things we're gonna parse from the data. And we should be able to change this one now to use an empty val tree. Okay, so the condition is an item type. So we'll need to parse out an item type. I think the condition's an item type. Yeah. Okay, so that's item type, parse word. Come on. Oh, geez, that took forever. Parse word, data, get child. What's up? Why is this so slow? Oh man, sometimes when your IDE makes you actually type stuff out, right? Data.getChild. Condition. This is a bunch of item. Oh no, this is this. I already have a function for all this. Get item type. I'm holding the escape key. Really? Come on. Escape. My God, what's up? I know when you're used to using autocomplete, then all of a sudden it just doesn't work. It's like you're in the pits. I'm like, I don't want to have to go look up this function name. I can't remember 55,000 lines of code myself. Just I'm pretty sure it's just get item key. No, it's get item type given a key. That's it. It's exactly what I was just typing. Get item type for data get child condition. That's totally wrong though. We can't actually load a condition. Make flashcards? Good suggestion, Born Snipe. I'll flashcard it all out. That'd be like 55,000 flashcards. But it'd be so easy to remember. Okay, it doesn't know the condition yet. But it'll know the condition after it sets its area pause. I guess we could use world pause at this point. I think there's a function called getItemType for key, and that's what we need to call. So the condition. Just add the line numbers back to cards. Yeah, it would. And then like punch a few holes in them. Yeah, there it is. Condition is all that stuff. Door.key condition. Biscuit door. See, it needs to apply the key condition here. The chat's not appearing now? Hello, chat. Yeah, it's just empty today. Well, I don't know. I don't know what to do right now. It's just empty. It looks like it might not have connected to the web or something. Guess we don't have no chat this video, but oh well. I'll try and fix that next time. Okay, I'm not gonna worry too much about the key condition just yet. Just parse it out. Whatever it gives me, it's fine. Yeah. Okay, locked is data get child locked get in. Oh god, I'm gonna restart Xcode. This is so annoying. I can't use autocomplete today. Screw that. What's up, Silly Billy Bear? Life is amazing. I do what I love. I love making games, man. I love coding. I love making art. I love making music. I love that I'm creating my own game. This is so great. This is so fulfilling. I've dreamt of this life since I was like a teenager, like 20 years ago. I was like, wouldn't it be so cool if I could make all my own games myself? If I could make all my art, all of the sound, and do the programming and just make a game however I wanted. It's always been my dream. And I'm living that dream right now. And it's awesome. Okay, it is re-indexing everything. So maybe that'll help once this is done. Okay, open, same thing. We can load that from data. Yes, BitX, I do my own sounds and music. Yes, I do everything. I also do business, which is very much an overlooked skill in game development. Most people do not consider business as part of like your core skills you need to have as a solo game developer, but seriously, business is important. Same childhood dream? Nice. Right? Well, you can do it too, man. If I can do it, anybody can do it. I don't have any sort of special skills. You see me do everything I do on a daily basis. I just know how to code and make art and make music and sort of do business. I do marketing, kind of, you know. I'll post a tweet every day. That's marketing, right? I'm here live streaming. That's marketing. Direction. Yeah, thanks, Silly Billy Bear. Appreciate you saying that, man. The problem is that I keep feeling constrained by others' tools and code. Huh. What tools and code are you having to use then? Is there something that's really constrictive about it? The direction, what's that? That's door.getDir. I do have, stuff like Unity. Learning OpenGL so I can just roll my own solution. Oh, nice. Okay, so you feel restricted by any type of tool like Unity, Game Maker, and all that. Nice. Salad Dongs, have you at least seen GLFW? I'm sure you've seen this before. GLFW is like, I think, is a great place to start if you want to learn OpenGL and you want to just have it already support Windows, Mac, and Linux. This is a great thing to start with. I'm sure you've already heard of GLFW, so I won't harp on it or anything. Okay, so get the direction can be parsed with it's a compass direction, that's right. So compass dir parse word get stir, and this is words. Okay, dirs. I think dirs. Nothing. Sometimes you don't like how the tool code is set up, right? Or not knowing enough about what's going on under the hood. I hear you on that one for sure. I've always disliked things like Game Maker myself because I didn't know what was going on under the hood and I couldn't change it. That's what I dislike the most. Is if there's something in Game Maker that I didn't quite like the way my game came out, I felt so lost at that point, you know? Like, I love using an engine like Cocos 2DX, which is all C++ and completely open source, so I can go, and if there's a bug or there's something, this one little thing I want to tweak in the game engine, I can go and change that easily. Oh, so you prefer, so SDL kind of does what GLFW does, I'm sure, yeah. Yeah, simple 2D engine, right. Yeah, totally. Yeah, I hear you on that too. The 3D versus 2D and how much work you'd want to do and all that, yeah. Yeah, input allow. No, this isn't right. Okay, so the direction needs to be applied later, I guess. So does condition, really. Jeez, let's just do that. Condition K, item none. Direction K, dir none. Okay, there. We'll figure that out later. I hate the scenario of counting a bug and not be able to fix it. Right, yeah. Whew. No fixes, no tweaks, nothing. Trigger pause. Trigger pause dot set given data get child. Trigger pause. Distance. I think distance is also a V3F, yeah. There's a game maker game on my Steam library that won't run. Whoa! Then they have to wait for Yo-Yo Games to address it. Oh my god, that's like the ultimate nightmare situation as a game developer for me. It's like I would feel so bad if I made a game and sold it to somebody and it wouldn't run on their computer and I could do nothing about it. Did I go to college? Yes, I did, but I was already making games at that point. I started making games when I was 14, actually, and I published my first. I tried to self-publish my own game when I was 15 years old on BBSs. This was before the internet. So anyways, I was on BBSs, and literally, my game came on 3.5-inch floppy disks, man. It was so cool being able to make my own labels. I was like, yes! I have my own 3.5-inch floppy disk. I have my own labels printed up, and I like stuck those labels on. The labels were black and stuff with white text. It was a cool moment in life. I was 15 years old, and then so basically I already knew how to code, man. And when I went to college, there were no girls at my college, and I was like, college sucks without girls. I'm leaving. So I left. I never finished college. But I learned a few important things there, but mostly I just had fun. I really liked it. I wish I kind of would have finished just so I would have deeper connections with friends, you know? All right, so played lock. Of course, that's false. Duration. Data get child duration get float flags parse flags. I think we're gonna need door component flags now. Yeah, that's gonna come out wrong. So let's let that go, compile. Now we need these door flags. Okay, so we got some door flag words and copy the AI flags array. I forget what door flags even are. Door flags. tough because I want to study computer engineering at university, but I would have to go to community college for 2 years, or I also got into FCU. I hear your challenge right now, man. What to do? Just crawling with females, but engineering sucks there. Oh man, the dilemma. Oh, I don't know what to tell you, man. We're thinking about the devs bug issues that the Yo-Yo Games has stated they already fixed the problem. Oh man, bastards. But clearly they just fixed something else that creates the same symptoms. Mm-hmm. I know, Billy Bear, dude. Oh. So we got like K door or something. K door. That's not it either. These are door types. There, door flags. Yeah, that's true. Salad Dogs brings up an amazing point for you, Silly Bear, Billy Bear. The first couple years of school are almost always general education stuff. So it might not be so bad. But it's pretty much the feeder school. Oh, I see. It was the stuff you learned of Java by Googling, right? Yes, you definitely have a struggle, man. I don't know what to tell you. Go with your heart. That's what I would say. Go with your heart, man. Allow your heart to have the time to know what it wants without the interference of your head or what other people's heads say. You know, all the mental ideas in your problem. Forget them all. Forget it. Forget what the mind even has to do with your problem and use your heart only. That would be my advice. Doesn't appear that universities don't really place much burden on teaching programming. Theory versus skill of coding. That was the case at my university. I went to the Oregon Institute of Technology, and they were much more focused on theory than actual coding. But actually, we did a lot of coding. We did a ton of coding at OIT. Okay, so now I need to load this stuff. Here in the door component. They funnel your attention. Yeah. Yeah, it's true. BitX has got a good point. Yeah. Your own education is always going to be more impactful, I would say, than some external education or miseducation. So locked. It's totally based on the condition. Man, a lot of this stuff needs to be loaded afterwards. Open. Of course, open is going to be false too. Trigger pause. There's something we can actually load. Trigger pause. Oh, that's the actual position. So trigger pause shouldn't even be loaded from data. Distance is actually called movement, which makes a lot more sense. Duration, that actually will load fine. Flags also. Stay open and shake. My fear is that I'll apply for a transfer. I won't get in where it's 70% of the transfers. Oh. True, Salad Dongs, yeah. Zilton, what's up, man? You're down, very, very down. Why is that, man? I'm sorry. Sorry to hear that. Okay, so now all the dynamic stuff needs to get applied. All this is dynamic data, which needs to be applied, but still in a data-driven, friendly way. So that's the trick now. And I think door components are going to have like a set data with pause type thing. In fact, yeah, I'm going to do that right now. Add a render, like render component has a good example. Set data with pause, given an EID data and a pause. Do the same kind of thing for door component, and we should be able to. Oh, yeah, direction needs to be kind of hardwired in there, which means we're going to need some direction words. Your life is crashing on you. It's the workload. School. Oh man, school. Ah, we're talking about school with another little thread here. Uh-huh. Where you'd have more fun. So we need another DIRS. We need compass DIRS. And the door component. These set data with pause. And I want to rename distance to movement. Okay, so going back into all these constants, need some proper compass directions. Okay, and then the door component will fail. This thing said data would pause. All right, we got the methods in place. What's up, Bacon Bandit? Wow, I thought it was stuck. I'm like, what? Stuck? Oh, semester, like a half a year of school, yeah. Okay, so now I got a function in place, so it sets the door component's data with position if it has a door component. And wait, it should compile now. And there's a place where I call all these set data with pauses all in the same place. I think it's here. Yeah, set entity pause. So health component, we're also gonna need data, door component here. There. So a door component could be initialized with its data when it's created. Okay. So now after all that, we're set up so I can finally do the last bits of dynamic data. Do you work for a game developer too, or is this your only job? This is my only job, man. I did this all, I started this whole project with absolutely no idea if it would work. And I had no income whatsoever starting this, except for some web development work that I was doing on the side at the time. I started this November of not last year, but the year before, 2014. And I said it with the intention that if I was able to, in the next like 3 or 4 months, if I was able to get a Kickstarter off the ground and get this game, you know, enough of a following and everything so that a Kickstarter would succeed, then I continue making Songbringer. But if it failed, then I would go get a job. And so thankfully the Kickstarter succeeded and it did well. And I was able to make Songbringer instead of going and getting a job. So that's my story with Songbringer and finances. Door components to David Plot. All right, so we need to grab everything from... Oh, we can parse the direction now. Get parse word data, get child, dir, get stir, and words is k words, or is it words? Words, k compass stirs. Yeah, thanks, man. Nice, Silly Billy Bear. Cool, man. We'll see ya. See you next time. Okay, hopefully that works. So basically now in here in the create big door tile, it should now be able to get the direction. Yeah, so all this data here just got to go inside that new method. Let me comment out some stuff that I don't think I'm going to need here. That should be it. And then, yeah, I think this stuff can go. Through at bash cipher is Drazu if. What's the at bash cipher? Oh, it's just a really simple cipher. It works by substituting the first letter of an alphabet for the last letter. Oh, and then so on. Just a reversed alphabet. That's all it is. Irk, rip, low, old. Wow. Hey, wizard! Drazu! Oh, wizard is that exactly reverses itself. As noted right here. Wow. Who knew wizard was such an at-bash reversible? Wow. There we go. Door component. Here's where we can go and parse the data. Now that we know our direction, or not, maybe. What we do in this case, so we need to be able to get the direction, though, if we don't. So, set the direction. If dir is k dir none, then we need the area no matter what. Autoref area. Yes, it's nice that it's such a simple cipher. String route 13 is similar, but I guess it's the opposite almost. All right, so yeah, if dir is none, then the dir is going to become area.getDir. Oh, if door.dir and this is what a private method. Man, this is such a convoluted method, but I think it's what I need to call. Wait, what do I get compassed or? Oh yeah, it's not that one. I need this one, get compass direction. And that's a simple method. Okay, so after we set the direction, we want to get the dungeon door. Gotta add this method too to get a compass direction from an X, Y, or a position. Man, this is turning out to be a lot of work. All I wanted to do today was get this working. But man, it's been a lot of data-driven fixing stuff that was should have been one way. But anyways. Okay, cool. Let's see if that method worked then. If this compiles correctly. Still got a few errors. Right. Okay, so let's see if that works. That never got called. Why is that? Let's take that part off. this is never getting called. Oh. Well, obviously, area creation needs to create door components. Nice. Door component. Door. Right? I'm not creating any door components anywhere else. No. So now we should definitely hit that breakpoint, and this will also tell whether it's getting that direction. Yeah, hit the breakpoint. High five. And it came out south, which is wrong. Where did it get south? Oh, because I clamped it to a compass direction. What do you spend it on? Well, you can always win another Steam key. Give it to somebody. So this is going to be empty string. And then we're calling parse word. Just return 0, which becomes a compass direction. But south could also be a compass direction. So how do I know that it's south and not none? Well, I guess I could use the string size. Yeah, I guess string size will have to do for that. So I'm grabbing a dirster. That's data get child dirster. If dirster dot size. Then parse the direction. Current version is 1.0.59293.5632. How tough was it to implement my own scripting language? Not tough at all. It's really easy. That was quick, man. It was simply just a matter of having a good parser, which Valtry is. It's awesome, and that's on GitHub, you know. So Valtry really helps make all the parsing for the script really, really easy, man. Yeah, you gotta check out that null video. Check it out. Okay, good. That time it was none. Nice. Nice salad dongs. Okay, so now with that line in there, we should get that, and it should get the compass direction based on the position. All right, so our position we gave it, 210, 132, 240, 120, that should be correct. It should come out as the right compass direction. But let's see that. Compass direction from vector. Let's see what vector it gets. Y1, right. Okay, that should be north. Dor dur is north. Very good. Okay, we dynamically applied the direction of the door. Awesome. Okay, the next dynamic thing we need is the dungeon door, which gives us some other stuff. So auto ref dungeon door is gonna be area.getDoor in the door.dir. I guess we should make sure that's not none before starting this little bit of magic. Okay, so now we should have the dungeon door. You've been addicted to adding kappa phases to everything? Hey, wait, Zilton, tell me something. Do kappa phases, is that something that even gets, like, used for you in your life? Do you actually use kappa outside of Twitch? Like, let's say you're at school or whatever and you say kappa. Do people know what you're talking about? Or if you're texting somebody, if you put kappa, do people understand that? Here's the important part, is setting the door condition. So our condition becomes constants get item type for key area dot get pause dot z, and then door dot key condition already. Oh yeah, dungeon door. Dungeon door dot key condition. I think. Oh, why didn't that work? Oh, door dot condition. Okay, this is the most important part. Oh, you photoshopped it on the other stuff. Nice, nice. Zilton, I was asking you something. I was asking if kappa extends beyond Twitch into your everyday life. I was wondering this. Like, for you and your world and everything where you're going to school, like, if you're at school and you text somebody and you say something, 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 kappa, do people, like, understand what kappa means? Or if you say it in conversation to somebody, you say, like, haha, kappa, do they know what you're talking about? No, they don't. Oh. Well, it's good to know we got our own thing then, huh? So we need to know about gear component now and game. Dungeon door on key condition. If it has a key condition and the player does not have... Oh, this is only for boss doors. If constants is switch for door.condition, door.locked. Can we name stuff? They're not with that vibe. Can we name a flag? Sure, what do you want to name? I can get rid of this here now. I'm behind that. So door.locked is gear.count door.condition is less than or equal to zero. This is a switch-based door, so I'll need to make this better for like key-based doors. Salt! The last thing is this, the color of the door. And I think this would be a good place to put it here in this switch-based part here. So yeah, switch-based doors, set locked, set color. Render is entity get render component. Oh, it needs to know what render component is now. All right, see you, Pedro. Right. Bodfu. Render.sprite.setColor. Hue.2R2RGB. I think that's the last bit of dynamic data to do. Let's see if that worked. I'm not going to set any breakpoints. I'm just going to run it. If it does work, we should see some red doors now. And they should move. Oh, yeah, right. Orange doors, that's right. And do they move? No, something's wrong still, but I think we got some of it working. Why is the chat broken? I don't know. It's been a quiet week. Every one of my streams this week, there haven't been people chatting. I don't know what's up. Maybe it's one of those weeks that people are vacationing or there's some big event going on or Twitch has got some event going on that's killing the internet for people. I don't know. A holographic AI character? Name them Colonel Sprite? That's a pretty good name for a holographic AI character. That should be like the name of somebody on a Red versus Blue episode. Oh, that chat box, it's broken. I don't know what's up with that. I did a high quality video yesterday. I did like a super high quality video and uploaded it, and something, I must have messed something up with Game Show. I don't know. Or Game Show has just broke itself. Condition, okay, so we got switch 1-4. That's exactly the right condition for this door. If it's a switch, good. We got the gear component for the player. Gear component for the player, active, true, has, size 250, yeah. We got a lot of data there.
What's up, baby?
Door locked. All right, so gear is good. Locked. Let's see if we can count the door condition. Let's get that count. It's second. You miss Red versus Blue? I don't know about the next season. When do they start those seasons? Oh, it's finals week for college, Chakra. Thanks for telling. Yeah. It could be some finals weeks out there. And see second. Here we go. Second, we got one. We got one of those. So that's going to return true. Or locked is going to be false. So door is already locked false and should stay locked false. That, okay, that got, that's good. And then we also get this fine. So why doesn't it open? It should have a movement already. Yeah, movement 49. Should have a trigger. Oh, there's no trigger pause. Oh, that's right. The trigger pause and the original pause. Oh. Got it. All we gotta do is set trigger pause and original pause. Original pause is the pause. Trigger pause is the pause. I'm pretty sure that's how I did it in the existing code. Ooh, this is great. This is so great to finally have this done. Data-driven door components. Let's make sure. Create big door. Yeah, so we didn't need any of this stuff now. And how did it set its trigger pause before? I guess it just set P from door component. New door component. Trigger pause, yep, which was the same thing as the position. Same thing as the original pause as well. And how did it set its original pause? Original pause. Oh, original pause is not meant to be set. That's correct. Okay, so yeah, door system handles setting original pause. And that's how it knows if it's moved something already. Yeah, okay, so I need to go back here and I need to make sure it doesn't set it original pause. Okay. Okay. Order a pizza for a streamer and not pay for it? It's like swatting but tastier. It has to be Pizza Hut. Do you guys have Pizza Hut, Zilton? Is it common, like in the UK, to even see a Pizza Hut? Oh, it worked, but they went the wrong way. That's funny. Yeah, perfect. That's exactly what I wanted to happen. The doors to open the opposite way. Oh man, this is great. I love opposite doors. Okay, so entity text. The right door needs to be flipped. And I think the right door needs some movement. Yeah, the movements are just messed up. Yeah. Okay, so movement for the right door is positive. For the left door is negative. You have tons of Pizza Hut? Really? Pizza Hut's big over there? I thought that was like... Do you like Pizza Hut? That's my other question. Do you like Pizza Hut? You have Domino's, Papa John's as well? Okay, we don't have Pizza Go-Go. I don't know what that is. But I've heard of Red Planet, and I've not heard of Pizza Express either. Yay! The doors are working 100%! Oh, now I can get rid of this. This BS. Where the hell is it? All of this, we don't need any of it. How many lines of code did I just get rid of? Not that many, because I got to do a data-driven door component. Was weird. Okay, I guess it's a little clear. Nah. Let's see that. Okay. New York pizza. Oh. Yeah, it's Italian pizza, huh? Hopefully that means it's better. Alright, does this sound like... We should have sound effects too. That's part of the whole profile component and all that. Yeah. Okay, sweet. Let's check all this in. Man, that was kind of a long path. I'm glad that's over with. Get status. Hey, what's up, Emma? I love the garlic butter dip too. This stuff's good. I agree the Domino's is tasty too. Oh. Really? Domino's forces you to spend 20 pounds or more? Bastards. Oh, we need to make sure the one door is in there too. So if I were at, like, wait, the boss door, I got a great way to just make boss doors by default. Instead of this being the two boss door, This is an auto entity, so I could just call it boss door. And by default, other stuff will work too. Don't need the one boss door or the three boss door. You once ordered pizza in school? That's great. Okay, I broke it. The boss doors are gone. Where'd they go? How do I stay motivated? Pema, that's a great question. And I'll give you this simple answer. I love what I do. I love what I do so much that I prefer to do it more than other things sometimes, you know? I love what I do so much. I love coding. I love making music. I love making art. And I love doing my own game. It's so awesome. It's so rewarding by itself. That's how I stay motivated. I do what I love, man. How can you not stay motivated if when you're doing exactly what you prefer to do? And that's my advice to everyone in the freaking world, is to find what you love to do the most and just do it. And you won't have any problems with motivation. I know, Arcane, I'm getting hungry too. Talking about pizza. Chakra, do I have any advice learning game development? Yes, I do. Preferably a book that talks about the design or structure. Well, no, I don't have any books I can recommend. I'm sorry, but the books that I read on game development were from the 90s, and they're way out of date at this point. But I was going to tell you to check out the extra credits videos. So they're not really a book, but this is probably some of the best advice you can ever get on where to start in game development, I think, these days. Extra credits, their videos are amazing. Oh my god. Oh, this is used to be simpler. Boss door. Auto entity. We weren't looking in for advice, just curious. Oh, okay. Nice, man. You prefer smaller projects. Nice. Yeah. See, then you already know what you prefer in game development. That's great. Smaller projects are pretty nice. It's really nice to get something done, you know, in like 3 months versus like 3 years. There we go. Boss door, auto entity. Super tight. Really awesome that now that's only 3 lines of code instead of like 100. And we should, well, let's verify one more time. That's good. And I'll verify the other types of dungeons. You're doing a game jam? Cool. Oh, you're doing the low res jam. Whoa, that's some crazy shake for sure. I like it. I like the door too thing. Oh, BitHex, nice suggestion here. Anything that has the words design patterns in it seems like a good book, right? I won again. Wizard Food won the parking. So dungeon 2, most structured text, nice. whoops, I didn't want to go up there. Okay, so this dungeon should also have its boss doors, and they should be totally fine. the key. Let's make sure if I get the key, that's dungeon two. Or the switch, I mean. Switch 2-4 is on, then I should be able to get through those doors. I downloaded tools from early 2000 so I could make a working Game Boy game. Really, the Game Boy does or doesn't? I never knew this about the Game Boy. Alright, cool. The doors work fine for this dungeon. Whoa, what's going on here? Anybody else see that? That door started drifting backwards. Look at this. What's going on? What's going on? It's freaking me out. It's like... sneaking its way back. It's like, yeah, let's go on back. And Jib is so messed up. Jib's got like this weird Z. Okay, anyways. Let me save here. We'll fix that, but I do think it's a good point to just check in at this point. Okay, boss door, data, good. We got that get compass direction, that's public now. Got a new auto entity function, which you can take data, which I don't need anymore, but I guess I'll keep in case I had any custom data at some point. Door components set their data with the position, so they can be loaded dynamically. There's the new auto entity function. All entities now create door components if they have them. The big door tile, all this code got rid of it. We now have compass directions though as words. South, 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 southwest, west, northwest, north, northeast, east, east, southeast. One more word should belong in there. There's a special number for none. Which is -1, so that should be in there. In case, just in case, that word needs to be recognized. Mutinous. It's a series of various cutting-edge technologies. Cool. Invisibility skin? Cool. Right on, let me check this out, Mutinous. I'll add this to my pile of stuff to deal with. No, I'll check that out for sure, man. I love checking out stuff. Then I still have this one video I need to watch from that Hardboiled sent me a while ago. Anyways. Okay, one more. Keep on checking through this list here. Door flags have been added. Compass door flags. Here's the door component loading itself from data, and we don't need the code that's commented out there at the top. Condition can start as none. Trigger pause starts as zero. In fact, you don't even need to set that. Well, I guess it doesn't matter. Played lock, false, duration, movement, open, locked, flags. Direction can be hardwired. Let's see what we get if we do that. I want to create an empty door component. I just want to make sure that, oh, damn it. All right, good night, Jonah. Wow, that was a lot of code to step through to just to get in there. Anyways, condition comes out none. Locked should come out false. Open false. Trigger pop. Oh, let's just get through all this. Yeah, okay, so direction none. Movement should be zero. Trigger pause zero. Original pause zero. Start time and duration should also be zero. And the door component function for empty is based on movement. Okay, so movement is definitely zero. All right, yeah, that works fine, beautiful. Okay, data-driven door components, data-driven big boss door. This is the setData with pause method. It grabs the door component. Checks it, gets the area, sets its trigger pause, sets its direction if it doesn't have one that was set from the data. And then it goes and gets the dungeon door, it gets the dungeon door's condition, and then applies the switch-based door stuff, like whether a switch-based door is locked, whether the color of a switch-based door. And that should be about it. Yes, this is a good check-in. Okay. So the next thing to fix is the getting the doors so they don't close. I am 2 hours into the stream though, so I guess I'm probably done. But yeah, so the next thing I'll work on after I'm gonna call it quits here on the stream for now. But just to kind of recap what I'm doing today, I'm working on this. This is my ultimate goal, is to be able to run through this new dungeon. This is a puzzle-based dungeon. So instead of it being combat-based or focused on combat, I should say. It's more focused on the puzzle aspects of this game to make this game more feel like a Zelda game and less like a Diablo game or something where you would grind a little bit more or something else, you know. So anyways, it's puzzle, or there's puzzles in this game, and I need to start working on that. So this is a good way to do that, is create a puzzle-based dungeon. In this puzzle-based dungeon, you get the ability to meditate. And if you meditate in front of this big-ass door, it opens. And that's what I'm working on, this big-ass door that you can meditate to get through. So to do that, I made things better so I wouldn't have to rework as much code to implement those doors next time. And yeah, so what I'm gonna work on tonight is getting the doors. I don't know why they're closing on me automatically here, but if I go and open up this big boss door right here, let's see, I open it from this side. I go back here, it's gonna close right door. I don't know why. So I'll work on that. And the last thing I'll do is I'll actually go into the sandy area and start working on this. Just put this put it in there. So that's it, you guys. Thanks for watching, and catch you next time.